We know that preparation and readiness are not exactly the forte of the Trump administration, but it's actually getting worse and worse. Apparently, nobody thought to tell Donald Trump how to say the last name of Turkish President Erdogan when he visited the White House yesterday. And Donald Trump embarrassingly butchered his name, not once, but actually multiple times. When you see it written, let's say you're not in politics, right? And you see it written, you might look at it and say, oh, E-R-D-O-G-A-N. Yeah, what is it? Is that Erdogan or Erdogan? What is it? If you're even remotely aware of politics, you probably have at least once before heard it pronounced Erdogan. If you're the president of the United States and are welcoming President Erdogan to the White House, you might want to know how his name is pronounced. Apparently, nobody told Donald Trump, and obviously the idea that Trump would have known on his own. I mean, none of us are even considering that. Obviously, Trump didn't know, but nobody thought to tell Trump. And here he is thanking the Turkish president during a joint press conference yesterday and destroying his last name.
It is a great pleasure to welcome President Erdogan for his first visit to the White House in years.
Yes.
The American and Turkish peoples have been friends and allies.
Erdogan, multiple times during the press conference. Can you not get anything right? And this is not, as with the Shinzo Abe situation, as with the Angela Merkel situation, as with the Xi Jinping situation, it's not specifically about the act. It's not specifically about pretending to understand Japanese or refusing to shake Angela Merkel's hand or pretending to understand Mandarin. It's not about the specifics. It's about Trump can't be bothered to make note of any detail or make any effort to maintain diplomatic relations.
Yeah, and you get a pass every now and then, but now this is becoming routine. And you said it yourself, but if you're a mechanic or a plumber or
right.
a carpenter, you don't need to know how to pronounce President Erdogan's name. But
sure.
if you're the president of the United States, that's something you should at least be briefed on.
And it's a fair criticism to say, David, given President Erdogan's extreme regressive authoritarian nature, this isn't really someone Donald Trump should be friends with. Hey, I agree with you. I'm not the one who suggested to Donald Trump to praise all of the oppressive things that President Erdogan has been doing. But apply some sort of diplomatic care, and if you're going to invite this individual, if you're going to cheerlead the things that they're doing, at least pronounce the guy's last name correctly.
The thing is, I know that I'm not at all qualified to be president of the United States, so the fact that I know how to pronounce Erdogan's name and the guy that we elected,
right.
it's just very concerning that he doesn't know how.
Concerning is the most understated way you could possibly explain what this is. I like that. It's remarkably understated. And as a reminder, we found out that Donald Trump gets briefings and prep material that are limited to one page. Usually half the page is some kind of picture or a map. And there's 2 to 3 bullet points on that page. Couldn't someone have handed Trump a piece of paper where one of the bullet points was a phonetic spelling
yeah.
of Erdogan's last name or something like that? I mean, we're down to 2 to 3 bullet points and a picture. You'd think one of them could be here's the how you say the name of the person you'll be meeting.
It doesn't even have to be its own bullet point. You can just put his name, President Erdogan, and then in parentheses, the phonetic pronunciation.
At the top of the page, right.
Yeah.
It could just be the title. You don't even need to waste when you only get 2 to 3 bullet points when you're briefing the president. You don't want to have to waste one of those bullet points just on pronunciation. So I like your idea, Pat.
You
put it at the top of the page as part of the title. This was not missed by many of the viewers and listeners on our Reddit discussion forum. You can participate there at davidpakman.com/REDDIT. Today's program is made possible in part by Gamefly, which is sort of like Netflix for video games. They've got over 8,000 new and classic games for Xbox One, Xbox 360, PS4, PS3, Wii, and a bunch of other platforms. And you can also stream games. You don't even need a gaming console or a computer because you can stream games through your Amazon Fire Stick or Roku box and then use your mobile phone as the controller. You can play as many games as you want for one monthly fee. And if you find some games you want to keep, you can buy them for a low used price, never with due dates or late fees. And our audience can get a 30-day free trial at gameflyoffer.com/TDPS. The games are shipped directly to you with return envelopes included. no contracts, and you can also stream the games. I think I mentioned that. You can also rent games through the mobile app. Get a free 30-day trial for David Pakman Show viewers and listeners, and support our show at gameflyoffer.com/TDPS.